Yes, we are back again. Hallelujah. We are back again on the second part of this world. Amen. Now, as I was saying, I was reading at the book of Matthew chapter 5 from verse 13 to 16. Hallelujah. Now, the Bible says, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good work and glorify God who is in heaven." So you can see that your attitude is what has to bring glory to God. You can see that it's the way you do things that now has to bring glory to God. Amen. Many women has become something else in the church. Many women has become seducers. Many women are out to seduce pastors in the church. Many women are now, they are now having PhD. Amen. PhD, meaning pull him down. Whereas PhD is for something else. But seducers in the church, they are not qualified to have that PhD. Their own is pull him down. They pull their husband down. They are PhD in that. They pull the church down. They pull the society down. They pull, you know, good people. Anyone they see that is about to move higher, pull him down. Pull her down. And you say you are a Christian woman. You are a woman who goes to church. You are a Christian. You go to church. You are pulling down everything that, you know. You come to church to seduce pastors. You come to church to seduce young guys in the church. That is why I say, our brothers in the church, please, always be prayerful. Always be prayerful. Live a prayerful life. It's not all that glitters that are gold. Live a very prayerful life. Hallelujah. Jesus said, "Woman, you are the light of the world." Let your attitude stop pulling people down. Stop pulling pastors down. Stop pulling men, young boys, young men. Stop pulling them down with your seduction. Stop. Because these are the reasons why your prayers are not answered. I'm giving you the answer now. Because our God is a very good God. Our God is a very wonderful God. He wants to bless us beyond recognition. He wants to see us blessed. But if, as a woman, you possess all these characters, you are always telling people wrong information. You are always telling people how they are married to be scattered. There are some women, they are not ready to marry. And they don't also want you to marry. You have to know that. If you are a married woman, don't move with unmarried people. Don't. If you are a married woman, don't move with those that have already left their husband's house. If you are a married woman or you are not married yet, you are looking for a God-fearing person, please don't move with anyhow woman. Because anyhow woman will always end up anyhow. I've known a lot of women, they will have seven children for six fathers. Many women, seven children, six fathers. You want to tell me that is Satan? That is not Satan, it's your character that has not been making you to be stabilized. And if God is not taking, your children will possess it. Your children will possess it. I will never advise a person, a man that I know or love so much, to marry a woman that is coming from a background where the mother, we have about eight children for seven fathers, eight children for six fathers. God forbid. That's a very nasty attitude. That is not Satan. That is your attitude. You give room for him to operate in your life. If it is you, if you find 1 million euro on the ground, won't you take it? You take it. So it's not that. It's not, you know, the money was there on the ground. You find it on the street. You find it on the street. Are you going to give it to the police? Let us be real. You won't go. You won't go. And that does not make you a bad person. Because even pastor can do it. It's not a problem. Because you find it, it's only when you want to be a good Samaritan, you can go and give it to the police. You find 1 million euro on the street. You didn't go and steal it from somebody. You didn't find it in somebody's house, or you didn't find it. You just find it on the street. Maybe you'll be thinking, angel have put something there to answer you. The bottom line is that that does not make you a bad Christian. That does not make you a bad woman. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. And if you also go and give it to the police, it's also good. Most of the time, you can go and give it to the police. The police will not, they cannot find the person. They will use it. So you can take it. That does not make you a bad Christian. That is not what we are talking about here. So that is not this thing. But the fact here is this. You talk negatively into other people. If you are a Christian woman, you want a very sound marriage, but your character has nothing to be written about. Your character, there is no character, and you are waiting for that man. Let me tell you, a man of your type is who is coming your way. A man of your type. And many women today, they have men of their type and they are complaining. My man always beat me. My man always did that. My man always do that. When your mouth is more than a typewriter, he's a man of your type. He's a person that fits you. I want a Christian man this time. I want God to give me a man that fear him. I want God to give me a man that really respect him. I want God to be a man that really love him. For God to give you that man is good. What you are praying for is good. But are you a good woman? Are you a good woman? That is the question. Are you a good woman? Are you a good Christian? You are always from one place to another gossiping, talking about people. Gossiping about people. How having meeting of one person or the other negatively. And you expect a God-fearing man to come to you? No. And that does not bring glory to God. Let your light shine before men. That when men see you, this is when women, when men see you. So as a Christian woman, well, for a good man to see you, for a Christian man to see you, let your light radiate it. Let your character show it. Let your attitude show it. The Christian man will come that will marry you, respect you. And even if you have children before, he will help you take care of those children. He will claim it to himself. Let your character, we are talking of character here. Many women have no character. Many women have no attitude at all. Many women have no, they have no, they have no, they don't, they have no conscience. The Bible says, if a man way pleases God, he will make his enemy to be at peace with him. Woman, if your way pleases God, he will make your husband to love you and respect you. If your way pleases God, he will make that place where you are working for them to promote you. If your way pleases God, I'm talking to you, woman, that is watching me. Christian woman, you know your character. If your way pleases God, he will make life easy for you. You will not struggle. Because of you, your children will be blessed. Because of you, your friends, everyone around you will be blessed. Because of anything you touch, you lay your hands to do, will prosper. If your way pleases God, he will make your enemies to be at peace with you. Hallelujah. And for the few women that fears and respect God and are doing the things of God, I want to say congratulations. Don't step aside from it. Don't move with the crowd. Don't move with what people are saying against you. Just be moved by the Spirit of God that has been leading you. Maintain your marriage. Don't move with those that talk too much. Christian woman that has been maintaining her marriage, make sure that you move with Christians like you. Don't move with unbelievers. Don't move with PhD holders, seducers that have PhD in pulling marriages down, in pulling churches down, in pulling their society down. There are women, they are everywhere. They are just getting rampant every day. They are just many every day. They are just increasing every day. Because as they go to church, they recruit others. And how do they do that? They come back. You know, I come to serve God. Exchange of telephone. They start to exchange telephone. You are pulling that church down. Do you know that person before? Remember, that person that you are now colliding with, that you are now planning with to pull down the church, or to pull down the pastor, or to talk against the pastor, you didn't know the person from outside. You know the person right in that church. You didn't know the person anywhere. Many Christian women today, they go to church, The reason why they go to church is not to serve God. And when they know that you are a pastor, you know them, they will begin to fight you. They will begin to talk against you when they know that you know their mission. When they know that you are very intelligent, you are clever by the power of the Holy Spirit. People don't believe in discernment. I believe in discernment. Discernment is a very powerful thing. If you are a pastor, please go to God, pray, ask Him to give you the spirit of discernment, to be able to discern. To discern people. To know who is who in the church. To be able. There are many women now in the church. They go to the church in order to seduce the pastor, in order to seduce the young guys in the church. And if they see that the pastor is so, is really anointed and is having discernment, what do? They will begin to talk against that pastor. They will begin to talk against him. They will begin to talk against her. They will begin to talk against the church so that others will not come. But let me tell you, you are doing it. It's very good to you. Go and read the book of Proverbs chapter 14 verse 12. What you are doing is very good for you, but wait for the repercussion. Wait for the repercussion. God is going to pay you back in your own coin. And the worst of it all, it's not only you, your children are going to inherit it. So you can imagine how wicked you are, leaving a very big cost for your children. Because you can't contend with the church of God and expect God not to fight back. He will fight you, but He's going to reply you. It's going to be the time you never expected. Hallelujah. And of course, there is nobody that can pull down the church of God, unless if that church is not from God. Any church that the Holy Spirit is the administrator, any church that Jesus is the head of the church, He said, I will build my church and the gate of hell will not prevail. So women that are going from church to church, if they cannot do business in the church, all these their things they are selling, if they cannot do it, they say that church is bad, that church is this, that church is that. Continue. Don't change. Continue. Then your payday is coming. There is nothing without a payback. When you work, at the end of the month, you get your pay. So all what you are doing, you are going to get a payback. It's not going to be when you expect. But there is also news for you. The reason why you are still doing it and you think that, is because God is giving you time to repent. Do you know what they say? How are the mighty falling? God is giving you time to repent, but when you refuse to repent, there is a time that He will wait. He will not wait for you anymore. When that woman falls, He will fall beyond recognition. How are the mighty falling? So, woman, Christian women, I'm calling you today, come to repentance. Come to Jesus. When you go to church, have a change of mentality from today. Change from your evil way and wicked way. Change. Change is possible. All you just need to do is just to recognize your weakness. Recognize all these things that you are doing. Go to God in prayer and in fasting, and He will direct your path. He will forgive you, and He will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. Because the Bible said there is hope for a tree. There is hope for a tree. There is still hope for you, woman. Christian woman that is dividing churches here and there. That is moving from one church to another. That is talking against Christians, talking against pastors, talking against churches, talking against this, everything. You never talk against witch doctor. How many times have you talked against witch doctor? How many times have you talked against the powers of God? How many times have you talked against the generational curse in your family? How many times? Pastors that don't even know where you are coming from, don't even know your family, don't even know where you are visited. Many women, they have visited witch doctor. They have even... We don't have taken them to the grave to go and sleep, to go and have sex with dead people in the cemetery. Many women, they have done a whole lot of terrible things in the past. Okay, now that you have come to God, why don't you allow God to refine you, to change you? Still, you think as you have come to God, you are still doing all this, you have come to church with those kind of demonic powers. That is why you see some women, their attitude is unbelievable. Some Christian women, they say they are Christians, or their character is unbelievable. Their character is unbelievable, unbelievable. You can't believe that they are believers. Because their agenda is not to come to church and give their life to Christ. Because they know where they are coming from. They have all the opportunity, they have all what it takes to give their life to Christ, but they don't just want. They don't just want. They enjoy what they do. They enjoy what they are doing. Their own is to make sure I go to church. These people will think I'm a Christian. I will even go and join choir. I will even go and, you know, I will even be the best person to the pastor, carrying, you know, following the pastor to be the assistant or secretary in the church. I will even be to be hospitality leader in the church. I will even be in the church so that they will not suspect me. So that they will never suspect me. From there, they begin to do their havoc. They begin to press buttons, gradually influencing others. Others that are serious, influencing them. Paraventure. Anyone is still doing that, God is going to expose you unless you repent. God is going to expose you and God is going to disgrace you unless you repent. The only way out for you is to repent. Confess your sins and repent. Because you can't pull down the church of God. And that same you thinking, saying, God is not helping me. When you know who you are, you really know that you are not a Christian. You really know that you are not a believer. And you are not ready to be one. Because you can do everything. Everybody has his past. Everybody has a past. But you will not come to repentance. Leave those things. What is repentance? Repentance is not just declaring Jesus as my Lord and Savior alone. It's turning away from your evil way and doing things God's way. After receiving Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then what you do, you now turn from those evil ways and begin to do things God's way. That's repentance. And you begin to look for who will nurture you. Christian, anointed pastors that will nurture you to grow, to grow, to grow. So if anybody is not laughing you with the past, that person will carry the load. But if you are in the church, you are not even willing to repent. You are in the church. You are singing. You are doing that. You are in the hospitality department. You are in the department of usher. You are in the department of a different kind of department in the church. No, in order to, for the pastor to take an eye off you. The Lord will expose you. The Lord will expose you. We are living in the time now that Holy Spirit is really working to expose evildoers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want to thank God for the lives of women who are still fearing God today and who are in the church, serious with God, and really they know why they're in the church. I want to say God bless you one more time. The Deborahs in the church. The Deborahs in the church. The Esthers in the church. I want to bless you. When I meet Deborahs, we all know the story of Deborah. You can read it in the book of Judges. She was a strong woman. She was very active with all her heart. Look at Esther, Queen Esther, in the book of Esther in the Bible. How she humbled herself because she knew what she wants. She humbled herself. She was not there to pull down the people, to destroy them. She wouldn't have achieved that level. I want to appreciate Ruth in the church today. You can read that in the book of Ruth. Ruth said to Naomi, your people will be my people. Because she was a Moabite woman. Moabite people, they were not to be associated with. But when she saw Naomi, she knew that Naomi is coming from Naomi is from God's side. So he said, your God will be my God. I will follow you anywhere. She was very wise. She was very wise. So that's what I'm telling many women today. Get wise. Be wise. Be wise. Be wise. Do the right thing. Do the right thing. And you will see the attitude God will take you. You will see the realm God will take you as a woman. He will so anoint you and he will so take you to a level in a foreign land. He will so take you to a level that you yourself, you cannot even understand what is happening through you. Things will be happening through you. When you lay hands on people, they will receive their miracle. You will cast out demons in the name of Jesus. You will do exploits. You can maintain, you will be able to maintain your home. All these things has to do with coming to God and putting your life in his hands. Not by preaching. I'm not talking to hypocrites. But that hypocrisy could be stopped today if you are willing. Hallelujah. Hypocrisy could be stopped if you are really willing. Hallelujah. If you are willing, hypocrisy could be stopped. Glory be to God. So my message today is woman. Woman. That is my message today. Woman, bring glory to God. Bring glory to God. Let your attitude, let your behavior, let everything about you bring glory to God. Please don't let people see you and say, I will never serve God again in my life. Don't let people see you and say, they will never go to church again. Don't let your attitude show that. Otherwise, you have a problem with God. You have a problem with God. God is not interested in fools, but God is interested in women that are very wise. God is interested in the women that are very wise. When you are a wise woman, God will love you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Now, I just want to use this opportunity to really, really, from my heart of heart, if you are a woman, you have been moving from church to church. You have PhD in pulling down churches, pulling down pastors, and pulling down your husband, pulling down the things around you. Please, I want you, after listening to my voice, I just want you to stand by any means you are using to view this channel right now. It's by your tablet or by your telephone or by your television. We are in every channel. Hallelujah. We are on Facebook. Just tap Pastor Eunice Sage. Pastor Eunice Sage. We are on Facebook. We are on Instagram. We are on Facebook. We are on YouTube. We are on Instagram. We are on WhatsApp. We are on Messenger. Amen. Just tap Pastor Eunice Sage. Amen. You will see everything you want to know there. Follow us up and your life will never be the same. So I want to invite every woman, you know, that has been thinking maybe their hope is lost, who have been living a double standard life. Amen. I want to invite such women now. Please just place your hand. You will see something will break out of you. That power that is making you to misbehave, to do things the way you don't like, will go out of you, and the power of God will come in. Amen. The power of God will come in and you'll be able to obey and love God. And even when you now go to church, your pastor will be surprised. And even people around, they will be surprised. They will say, she don't even bring things to sell in the church again. She's very decent. Now, can't you see the way she, after praying this prayer with you now, just touch your screen or just, you can sit down, you can. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for every woman that is listening to my voice, that has been living a double standard life, that has been confused, they don't know what to do, doing the things that they don't want to do. Father, I pray for such women today, for the power of God to change you, for the power of God to remove all those evil attitudes in the name of Jesus. I declare upon your life that the Spirit of God will come upon your life to help you and to release you into your God-given destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. And I also want to pray for every woman that has been really obeying and following God. I want to pray that the grace of God will be sufficient for you. The mighty hand of God is upon you to do exploit for him in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, I thank you and I bless you for the life of everyone that will be viewing me today, that has been listening to my voice in the name of Jesus. And of course, men, listen to this message as well. It will benefit you and it will help you a lot. Hallelujah. Glory be to God, our Savior, in Jesus' mighty name. Now, if you want to give your life to Christ and you know from the depth of your heart, you know it's not by going to church. I'm not talking of just going to church. I'm talking of giving yourself to Christ. I'm talking of Jesus Christ having his way in your life. I'm talking about Christ being your all and all. If you want to give your life to Christ, I just want you to say this after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you today. I want to serve you with all my heart. I believe, Lord Jesus, that you are the Son of the living God. You came and you died on the cross for me. You went to the grave for me. And on the third day, you resurrected. And today, I give myself to you. I give everything that concerns me to you. I give my household to you. I give my life to you. Everything that I do for a living, I give it to you. Take absolute control. Remove my name, Lord Jesus, from the book of death and put my name in the book of life. From today, Lord Jesus, I declare you as my Lord and personal Savior. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You see how simple and easy it is. That was what I said many years ago. My life changed completely. Hallelujah. You have said that and your life will never be the same again. I pray for every viewers, everyone that will be viewing me right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that the anointing of God will locate you for greatness. I pray that the Spirit of God will follow you all the days of your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of God. Holy Spirit of God. Come and take control in the life of everyone viewing me right now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, precious Father. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Ancient of Days, for what you'll be doing in the life of everyone viewing me. In the name of Jesus, I break the power that does not make people to sleep at night. You woman, you man that is watching me right now, you cannot sleep in the night. Because of sexual harassment, you cannot sleep in the night. Because of evil dreams, you cannot sleep in the night. Before you close your eyes, you start seeing dead people around you today. By the authority vested in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command those nightmares, stop in the name of Jesus. Stop in the name of Jesus. Nightmare that is troubling you, I command them today, stop in the name of Jesus Christ. Everyone viewing me, I release the fire of the Holy Ghost into your room. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost into your bedroom, your living room, your toilet, your bedroom, everywhere, your compound, Holy Ghost fire. I release it into your home right now for protection. Holy Ghost fire to consume anything Jehovah God has not planted in your home. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And you that is yelling to be delivered, I say be delivered today. Be delivered today. Host of heaven, locate that woman. Locate that man that is yelling, that doesn't know what to do anymore. That doesn't know what to do anymore with her life, with his life. Spirit of God, locate that person for mighty deliverance tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. I cover you all with the precious blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus. Everyone watching me right now, you man, you woman, children, husband, wife, families, I cover you all with the blood of Jesus. I cover your bedroom, your sleep with the blood of Jesus. I cover your going out, your coming in with the blood of Jesus. I cover your work, your business place with the blood of Jesus. I cover your children's school with the blood of Jesus. I declare and I decree upon your life that you will make it. You will not die as a poor person. You will not die as a confused person. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will not die as a nonentity. In the mighty name of Jesus, the God that located Joseph is locating you now. Everyone watching me right now, that same God that located Joseph, that same God that located Joseph, that same God that located Joseph is locating you right now. It's locating that country where you are. Things are not working for you. Things are not working for you. I say from today, things will begin to work for you. You, this man that is watching me, this woman that is watching me, from today, things will begin to work for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I say the Lord is anointing you today, even in the presence of your enemies, in the mighty name of Jesus. All what it takes is just for you to get closer to God, get closer to Jesus. He will begin to do amazing things in your life. Your life will never be the same again from today. Whatever country where you are watching me from, I say begin to possess that country. Fear not, children of God. Fear not this man. Fear not that woman. Begin to possess. Say you are a possessor. Just say you are a possessor. Begin to possess. Begin to possess. Begin to possess. Move from glory to glory. Ha! 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 In the name of Jesus, I say move from glory to glory by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. You woman, you man that is watching me right now, move from glory to glory. Move from victory to victory. Move from success to success. It shall be well with you. It shall be well with you. Everyone watching me right now, say amen. These words, they are not ordinary words. They are anointed words. In the name of Jesus Christ, as you are sleeping, you'll be hearing these words in your sleep. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I use these words to replace every nightmare in your dream. In the name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If you are watching me right now, anytime you are watching this video, take water, and as I call the name of Jesus 7 times, just take water. You may not even need to say anything. The word of Jesus that comes out of my mouth is released into that water. Just drink it. Drink it, and you begin to see God moving mountains for you in the name of Jesus. Now, as I call Jesus 7 times, take water. Let the words that I called 7 times enter into that water. Drink it. Give to your children to drink. The name of Jesus is powerful. The name of Jesus is a mighty strong tower. Anyone that runs into it is saved. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to God Almighty. In the name of Jesus, let the power of God be released into that water. In the name of Jesus, let the anointing of God be released into that water. In the name of Jesus, let the fire of the Holy Ghost be released into that water. In the name of Jesus, let the power of God be released into that water. In the name of Jesus, let prosperity come into that water. In the name of Jesus, healing into that water. In the name of Jesus, deliverance into that water. These 7 times that I call the name of Jesus, everything that I pronounce, when you are watching this broadcast, when you are watching it, take water. I release the name of Jesus into that water. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost into that water. I release the anointing of God into that water. I release breakthrough into that water. I release prosperity into that water. I release fruitfulness into that water. And I release the peace of God that surpasses all understanding, coupled with financial breakthroughs into that water. As you drink it, your life will never be the same again. Have you forgotten the name of Jesus is a mighty strong tower? With the name of Jesus, we can do exploit. In the name of Jesus, we break through left, right, front, back. There is no power that can stand the name of Jesus. That is why we can stand with our head high and speak. Because he that is backing us will not back off. Jesus is backing us, he will not back off. I say Jesus is backing you up from today in the name of Jesus. Whatever you do from today, you shall prosper in it. Anything you do from today, you shall prosper. You shall prosper. You shall prosper. You shall prosper in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. In Jesus' name. By the authority of heaven, I declare and I decree that from today, everyone that is watching me, your life will move forward. I declare and I decree that from today, everyone watching me, those that want you to go down, they will go down while you will be lifted. I declare and I decree in the name of Jesus that from today, every wicked power that has been tormenting you, today they are bounded for your sake. They are bounded for your sake in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Everyone that is watching me right now, I declare and I decree by the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will be making it from today. I take away stagnation from your life. I take away retrogression from your life. I take away shame from your life. I take away poverty from your life. I take away setback from your life. I take away everything that Satan wants to see in you. I roll them away in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus said, I wish above all things that you prosper, you be in good health, even as your soul prospereth by the power of the Holy Spirit. I say you are prospering from today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The embargo over your life is lifted in the mighty name of Jesus. The siege over your life by the enemy, I say they are destroyed and broken in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every power that is making sure that you don't make it, those powers, they have been destabilized today. They have been destabilized today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the mighty name of Jesus, the snare over your life is broken. The snare over your children is broken. The snare over your family is broken. The snare over your husband is broken. The snare over your wife is broken. In the name of Jesus. Those that say you will not marry, I say the lie. I say the lie. I declare your wedding ring will be given to you this year. You that man, you that woman, believe in God for a spouse. Receive your spouse now in the mighty name of Jesus. You that man, you that woman that is believing God for children, receive now in the name of Jesus. Receive now in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive now in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive now in the name of Jesus. Receive the fruit of the womb right now. Receive the fruit of the womb right now. Receive the fruit of the womb right now. Receive right now by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus, the fruit of the womb. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say by the power invested in the name of Jesus, you will be successfully married this year. I say you will be successfully married this year. You will be successfully married this year. You will be joyfully married this year. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your faithfulness. Thank you, Jesus, for your faithfulness. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you, Lord. I cover you all with the blood of Jesus. Shalom. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.